evening, calling to order the planning board meeting of February 8th, 2023. Everybody can stand for the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
My name is Mike Mandel, I am the vice chair of the planning board. Paul Sanders.
Here.
Steve Cristiani.
Here.
Mr. McCrory.
Here.
Mr. Monahan.
Here.
Mr. Ferry.
Present.
Mr. Warren, absent. Mrs. Heather. Just for your information, each project, the applicant will explain the project, agency comments, board members' questions, and comments. Then we'll have public portion. We ask that anybody who's going to speak on any of these subjects, the public portion, limit your time to 3 minutes. And if you're here for the La Familia restaurant, that has been postponed to a future date. I don't know what time, when it will be. First on the evening is Fisher's site plan. Come up, sign in, and state your name for the record.
Good evening, Pierre Levesque, I'm the architect of the applicant.
Could you please explain here the project?
I'll give a little history. So this original subdivision occurred in South Nyack, and the map is dated March 2005. Robert Fisher, the applicant, purchased this property in May of 2022. And Orangetown adopted the Village of South Nyack zoning code with modifications last October and placed this property in the critical environmental area. The house was placed within the building envelope as described in the original subdivision map, and that zone is the RG8. Due to the topography, both the house and the carport are located on the western portion of the property along Central Avenue and College Avenue. And this lot fronts on both College and Baraka with the address on Baraka. So I have two fronts to deal with, and one, two, three, four easements to deal with. So the building envelope is in mostly in the western portion of the property. So we've located the house within that. And because we have a sewer easement dividing the property from the south portion to the northern portion, we've placed a carport up on College Avenue on the southern portion south of the sewer easement. It's a small house. We have the first floor square footage at 908 square feet and the carport at 616. Maximum coverage allowed in this zone is 50%, I mean 30%, and we're asking for 50. So we need a variance for coverage. We need a variance for side yard, we need a variance for total side yard. And the carport requires a variance to be located in the front yard, as well as coverage and height variance as determined by Director Slater. Additionally, there's a section in the local law that requires that this carport front on a road or dedicated street, that's still to be determined. So we're not sure how to proceed with that yet, and I'll work with Director Slater to try and figure that out, and as the time develops, what's going on in the South Nyack roads, we'll have a better understanding of the variances we need to apply for.
Well, thank you. And with the comments, PRC has no additional comments beyond the comments made by other agencies for this project. Office of Building, Zoning, Planning, Administration, Enforcement, letter dated January 26th, 2023. There are 9 comments. Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, letter dated February 6th, 2023. There are 18. Engineering, February 7th, 2023. They have, they state the following: the application demonstrated there are potential significant impacts with respect to drainage can be mitigated. Therefore, recommend the official site plan be approved to drainage subject to both project comments. However, which are 8. However, in the project description, they have, it's 4 times. Home portion of the development, including stormwater management detention system, is located on the portion of the lot that fronts directly on Kakarak Avenue. And in fact, it's the house and everything that is located on College and Center, whichever one it is at that point. Okay. Bureau of Fire Prevention, January 24th, 2023, has 1 bullet on the site plan review. Department of Planning, Austin County, letter dated January 27th, 2023. Recommend the following modifications. They have 14 comments. Rockland County Center for Environmental Health, January 11, 2023. They have 1 comment. Rockland County Sewer District Number 1, letter dated January 20, 2023. They have 2 comments. Alfred Gotti, Orange and Rockland Utilities, email dated Tuesday, January 3rd, 2023, states the proposed work will most likely be in conflict with existing gas service. Please contact ONR's new business department for all disconnect, reconnects, and load increases. Rockland County Department of Health, 111-23 consensus to the town of Orangetown Planning Board, serving the agency. Orangetown ZBA, January 4th, 2023. Consensus to the town of Orangetown Planning Board serving as lead agency. Orangetown ZBA, January 4th, 2023. No comments at this time. Please send future correspondence for review. Rockland County Environmental Resources, January 3rd, 2023. The project is out of the jurisdiction of the agency. And no further comments. Rockland County Highway Department, January 5th, 2023. This project is out of the jurisdiction of the agency and no further comments. Rockland County Department of Health, 111-23. Comments attached. From Scrocco and Youngblood, the letter dated August 1st, 2022. From Kerr, another set to you. Sorry about that. Architect, we have a narrative attached. We have a short environmental impact form attached. We have a letter from Melissa and Barry Shore, 9 Bacharach Avenue, received February 7, 2023, with attachments.
Just that Brooker is 12 comments, not 8.
Oh. Thank you. 12 comments, Brooks.
He got fired. Yeah.
Mr. Andrews.
So, in your district, the carport is like right on the street?
Yes.
And that street is College? College, where you allowed on that?
Yes. That is College that it's on. College and Center on the, if you look at the, this map. Looking at this map.
Right.
It's good that new way. Where the Denzin Road is a curve right here.
So how,
this is College, this is Central.
So how are you gonna, it's going to be pretty difficult to back out of that driveway or back out of that carport. You got a curve in the road.
This is the carport, the curve right here.
Right. that limits your site distance, correct?
Agreed. I've got no other place I can put this. That's the bottom line, you can't go anywhere but here. The sewer isn't in the way, it can't go down here because of the building envelope and easements. There's two easements down there that reduce the width to less than 25 feet. So this is the only location we're able to put a carport.
You can't move that carport back a little bit?
You mean off of the street?
Yeah, I mean, isn't that the property line behind it here?
The carport's within the property.
What's behind it?
Here?
Yeah.
It's 15 feet to the property line.
15 feet to the property line. And you don't want to move it back 15 feet, or is that going to cause another variance?
Well, it will cause another variance. The variance I'm really looking for is placing in the front yard. That's the first variance. The second one is coverage.
You're going to need variance for the carport, which is zero.
That's what I'm talking about.
So,
yes.
Well, if you move it back 15 feet, would that make it better?
Well, if I move it back 15 feet, then I'm on the other property line.
Okay, but it's not, and it's not as such a hazardous backing out of the carport going into the road.
I think
the road's probably not that busy, but still, I see a site problem and everything. I mean, is the carport going to have like walls up on it, or is it just going to be all open?
It's open.
Roof?
It's open with a roof. So you'll be able to see coming and going, and there's only one property down here on the south
mm-hmm.
that this College Avenue has any access to.
Right.
And then on this corner, did you visit the site?
No.
There's a garage right here.
Yeah.
And the main street coming down comes this way and goes to the north. So sight lines are open, you can see what's coming, and the traffic is going down.
There's a one-way street coming down there.
Yes, it is one way.
The house that you're going to build, is that going to be all on steel?
It's on piers with steel posts and a steel platform that the house gets built on. So the disturbance to the ground is minimal.
Right.
Same thing with the carport. The carport sits up on piers and steel posts.
I have nothing further. I'll wait for the public comments.
Yeah, I
happen
to say actually, but where is the closest property? Other house?
It's down here.
Yeah.
And then there's a house further up here. There's a house down here. And Baraka. That's here.
Yeah, it looks like you got a lot of issues with this application. I mean, a lot of variances. If the carport is giving you so many crazy issues, why not just a driveway as opposed to a structure?
Graves like this.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. There's no way to get a driveway, which is why we want this room.
It's like a parking, you know, instead of a structure right on the road.
I have no flat ground parking.
Mm-hmm.
And the variances that I need are side yard for the main house, total side yard for the main house, and that's it for the main house.
What about the lot coverage?
The lot coverage is principally because of the carport. And the carport needs a variance for being in the front yard.
Okay.
And I need a height variance. So there's the three variances.
Yes. Now, Rockland Plan has a strongly worded letter here. Permitted development that doesn't comply with the bulk standards, and said undesirable land is present. They recommend scaling back this plan.
Mm-hmm.
Would you follow their recommendation?
No, because they don't have the correct zone.
RG8?
RG8, but they recommend that it's in the 12HC.
Well, they talk about...
There's a conflict there. We have to comply with the subdivision zoning requirements. So there is a conflict there. I can't scale it back. If we scale it back anymore, it's an unusable lot. And it's a building lot that was subdivided, and we're permitted to build on it.
Yeah. But you don't want to build something that conforms to the zoning laws?
Well, I've done the best I can.
One of the stuff we do in the planning board review is to look at the intent of the zoning.
Right.
And I take that seriously about...
I do too. We didn't come to this like...
Can you just clarify the lot coverage percentage is significant due to the steepness of the slope, correct?
Yes, that's correct. So the calculations, the steep slopes calculations are what has caused this variance.
That's limited your usable space.
Right, so I understand that percentage coverage is sort of misleading. It's a really large lot.
Yeah.
It just works out because, you get that reduction because you can't build in that area. As far as the variance is concerned, that is a variance that most of the, most of the time does get granted because of the hardship that is naturally there.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to make sure that you understood that that's why it's so high. It's not like he's building out to every corner of the lot. It's due to the steepness of the slope and the easement and things like that. So it gives him a lot of restrictions to work in.
Yeah.
And it's still South Niagara, it wouldn't be considered a critical environmental area?
It is in a critical environmental area.
Right.
But
so
it wasn't when it...
Yes, it was.
Oh, that's what I said. Always has been.
All of South Niagara was in critical environmental area before they dissolved, and the town adopted amended zoning.
Yes.
The town board opted to take some of the areas that are flat and not riverfront and not steep slope. They were removed from critical environmental area. But this one would have been in to the location.
That's it. I just have concerns about the zoning code not being applied in the case. That's it.
That's fine.
I don't have any additional comments. It's just a lot of the comments on this are already reviewed statements in your concern about not having drainage calculations. You're taking consideration of the impact this structure will have on the surrounding areas that still need to be figured out and finalized. So
we did submit the calculations. Why they didn't get to Brooker, I don't know.
Okay.
Bruce Peters has those calculations. There seems to be confusion at some level that this mitigation system is a detention system. It's not a retention system. Mr. Peters' letter really addresses a retention system and not a detention system. Brooker realizes that it's a detention system. So essentially, it's not percolating water into the landscape. Retention does, detention does not. This holds the water, and then as it goes through the manhole, it leaches out into the level spreader that we have downhill. So we're not really adding water to the subsoils. So that's if there's a drain pipe on the side of your house,
right,
and goes to the level spreader and spreads the water out on the lawn.
And there's no property or road or anything down below that spreader that would be impacted by...
The spreader lands
right
here.
Yep.
Which is, well over 35, 40 feet from the property line. And there's plenty of land here to mitigate that, which I think is why Brooker is in agreement with the mitigation process.
Okay. I'm going to process that. I'm going to go.
Yeah, it is tricky building on a slope like that, right? I mean,
that was the reason why we went to Peters and to create a level platform for us to build off and reduce the land disturbance.
There are a lot of comments to deal with, so I'd like to hear from the public and see what the neighbors have to say.
All right, two questions. Anything else to tell us?
That's all.
Is that okay? Right, and we're working with Director Slavin, and I spoke to Superintendent Highways last night, and they're trying to find out which roads over there are legitimate roads, and public roads and private roads, and so that's going to have to be decided well in advance what's going on. As far as the drainage, we sent it here last night. We'll tell the sheriff to even get back to them to move on with that. So, short EAF has to be corrected. So, archaeological 12B and 20 has this waste.
I'm going to address that to Mr. Slavin.
No, that's it for the Rockland County Planning Board. It's got to be corrected.
Right, but we did the EAF after
some
discussion. I don't know why they're asking.
Because it would not have gotten, their package goes out 30 to 45 days prior. That's why.
So they might not even have it.
They wouldn't have a revised one, no.
Okay.
And they wouldn't even consider looking at it.
Right.
It's a comment, which obviously it has been revised. So
right.
If the board was, say, giving you approval tonight, then they would ask for an override.
I know the construction company's going to figure out where they're going to park their equipment and everything, but I don't think they need to keep working on that property.
Was that a contractor already looking at it and figuring that part out?
Now, the variances. Okay, this is at a building department. It's five, so we need five variances. So I have my answers just clarified already. And there's now you got two easements that I see, and you said there's four.
One. Mr. Chairman, it's actually seven variances. Or
seven?
Yeah,
I'll tell you. Okay, with the easements now. There are, how many easements are there on the property? Because it's hard to tell from this map.
There's a sewer easement here.
Okay, this is the one that goes all the way down.
Right, under your left hand.
Over here?
Yes, that's the sewer easement.
That's the one that goes along here?
Right.
It starts up here, goes all the way down?
Yes.
Right, that's sewer.
Over here where it says easement, code L153P2065, this was actually an easement that was granted to Nyack College.
On the side here?
Yeah, that's been abandoned.
But it's still an easement.
You see that dotted line that goes all the way down?
Yeah, I see this one here. So
yes.
I said 1898 goes down to 1725, correct?
It goes all the way down even further. Keep going right across Baraka.
All right, this used to be the Nyack College?
Yes. It was a walkway, so they could put in pedestrian steps, whatever.
But it was never done?
It was never done, and it's going to be abandoned.
On the abandonment of an easement, you have to get something on that? Okay.
How is it reflected on the map?
It's reflected on the map. It starts up at Central, goes down to Bacharach. It was supposedly for a walkway in Nyack College. It can't be just abandoned unless we remove someone.
So what's the status of that easement, to your knowledge?
Well, Nyack College is dissolved. It's not there anymore. And
that doesn't make
that easement, when my client discussed it with them, they abandoned that easement. But why it's still...
Yeah, you have to go to the clerk's office and get proof that it was abandoned.
Okay.
Just because someone says it was abandoned doesn't necessarily mean that it has been abandoned.
That'd be the county clerk?
Yes.
Now, on that easement, I see there's a McAdam driveway.
That's a different easement.
Who's that belong to?
So, this dotted line right here?
Yes.
No, not that one.
Okay, which one are we talking about?
It starts up here at 102. It starts right there.
So it's even one.
here.
Oh, this one, all right.
Right. This goes all the way. That's an original easement to the Siler property, which is here.
Okay, that's this whole section is an easement?
Yes, and then now it's been changed to this.
Okay.
Where it has the meets and bounds on it.
Okay, that's the leachy bounds?
And that's described right there, where you have it highlighted.
Right, and that, this is the new one, this is Con.
Right.
Okay.
That easement is to the Silers.
Yeah.
For the driveway, retaining wall.
Now, where's, that's what I'm trying to figure here.
That's the McAdam driveway.
Okay, that goes, that's the neighbor's property?
Yes.
Where does it go to? It's still on your property here.
Yeah, pull this forward.
Yeah.
It does this.
Oh, comes out to?
Baraka. Baraka.
Baraka, sorry, Baraka.
And the house is right here.
All right, this is the driveway.
Yes.
Okay, what else do you have, the other?
Well, there was an easement that's on the front, but that's been removed.
And do you have paperwork on that one?
I believe we do.
Okay, I'd like to see that too. Or if it's been removed, you have to show that it's been removed. Who are you? So you don't have to keep coming back with the problems with this.
Mr. Peters has asked for meets and bounds on this.
Right.
And we will provide that.
Okay. And it'd be, I think it'd be a little easier if we saw a map that showed the easements, right? Because it's very.
Well, I think.
It's a very crowded map.
One of the comments from Mr. Peters and Brooker was to set up a separate map with the steep slopes, and I think that'll clean it up and clarify a lot of things. Make it a lot easier to read.
Yes, definitely so. Definitely so. Okay. Now, there's no landscape map on here.
No, we have not done that yet.
Okay, they gotta show all the trees.
Yeah.
Sheet with any trees that you wanna remove, the rationale for it. Also, a letter from the neighbors talks about two large trees that have been removed. Are there any, stone wall that separates your property from the neighbor's property?
If you'll open up your map.
Does that create a?
These are the two trees.
Okay.
And the stone wall from the neighbor's property is down there.
All right, so, okay. That's a quite a high wall, so we don't construct any of that wall.
No.
Now, you didn't walk from the top to the bottom, you drove from the top and then walked to the bottom. Second, all in favor? Anybody from the public like to make a statement? Please come up, state your name, address. I'm glad you brought that. It's easy to see the from the letter.
Yes.
Red and yellow.
You just have to switch the microphone on. We'll just switch at the top.
Can you hear me now? No. Chuck.
What's your name, sir?
My name is Barry Scher. I own 9 Baraka Avenue. And obviously, this is a very complicated issue. So I took the liberty of printing a nice visual from Google Earth. And I'd like to walk through a couple of the very salient issues related to that, specifically where the property at 7 Baraka, which is outlined in this, for the most part, right, not to scale. Outline for the most part in this large black looks like the number 7. So our property abuts that both on the north and west sides. My wife and I submitted a letter to the planning board
via email earlier this week with our comments related to this matter, so you have those comments. Specifically, and it's very important, I want to reiterate that in no way should any of my comments this evening nor in that letter be construed in any way to preclude the development of Seven Baraka, but merely to further ensure that the surrounding properties and structures, dwellings, and roadways are properly protected during construction and development, as well as the use after. I'd like to highlight some of the more salient points and aspects of the development in this unique area of the former village of South Nyack, which is designated as a critical environmental area, right? Very steep, this is a very steep area, and soil erosion and water erosion is really the paramount concern of most of the residents in this area and the municipality as a whole. Our property near the western border and directly downhill from the proposed carport, we've got 15-foot walls. These are not retaining walls. These were not built as retaining walls. They're not constructed as retaining walls. They're not engineered as retaining walls. They are large walls in excess of 15 feet that were the foundation of a previous domicile on the property. That's depicted here. Well, I shouldn't say depicted. You can actually see it in the Google Earth photo. It's approximately 30 to 45 feet from the proposed building area. Okay. Removal. So the proposed carport here, depicted as the yellow X. If you look at the site plan for that, there were two trees that were being removed there. Those happen to be two of the largest trees on the property. The largest tree is 40 inches in diameter. Those two trees are 36 and 24 inches respectively. And obviously we're very concerned about water, soil erosion, et cetera. And while I understand that building on piers doesn't impact the ground directly, certainly nothing is going to grow under that. And anything that is maintaining that soil and holding that structure together, if that's no longer there, certainly the opportunity for erosion and problems are going to happen. Our house, Nine Baraka, it's 140 years old. It's built on a slab. There is no basement. It's not built on piers, as many of the houses in that development and neighborhood are. And any modifications to the soil and water above it would likely cause a significant issue because it is right there on grade. Concerns really don't stem from me just making this up. There have been some new homes that were developed on Willow Court. Depicted here, the yellow square, that's 2 Willow Court. And after that home, or during the construction of that home, there has been a negative impact to the surrounding areas. And I'm sure some of the neighbors who are here will discuss that further, but specifically 26 College Avenue here, which is on the southern side of our property, sustained some water damage. I see Pat is here, I'm sure she'll tell you all about that. Since that building has commenced on Willow in the last couple of years. I can tell you that silt and debris continue to flow and pile up on the unimproved portion of Baraka Avenue that is directly south and immediately downhill from this development. So if you were to drive down Baraka Avenue today, past 7, past 9, to the unimproved portion, you will find various parts throughout that road that have just dirt washed across the roadway. And that happens frequently during heavy rain. So obviously our concern is anything that disturbs this has that propensity to do that, has the opportunity. In 2022, these two properties down on Route 9W were impacted, okay? When this catch basin, there was a monster catch basin that was installed here when the subdivision was put in to contain all of the water. In 2022, this catch basin failed twice, causing massive erosion at both number 120, Route 9W, as well as 150, depicted in these pink squares here. So much so that the damage at 150 actually caused that road to be closed for several hours while the DPW cleaned that up. So that's a state highway that was impacted by that runoff.
That catch basin you talked me about, what was the cause of the failure?
I don't know.
No?
I can just tell you, it happened after a whole lot of rain. It happened more than once.
That was a South Nyack road, correct?
That's true. Well, no, it's not South Nyack. It's Route 9W. That's a state highway.
I'm talking about the storm, the catch basin up top. That's one of the failed.
this catch basin failed. That's south of all of what's going on here, but my point is, there is so much more coming off of this mountain.
What street is that on?
It's not on a street, it's in the middle of the woods. This is, if you were to look at this on the site map, the subdivision plan, the lands of Dansum, I believe it's...
The lands of Dansum, I know you all have that one. It's the original subdivision, you'll see that there's a whole area that was...
It was all dedicated to the village, I believe.
Okay, you gave me 5 minutes, so...
I'll wrap this up just real quick, right? I mean, the current plan, right, the current plot shows no consideration for water containment, or anything related to the carport. There is some water containment to the house. I don't know if that's sufficient or not. We have retained the engineering firm of Axel, Masher, and Zinger to visit our property to address this and protect our rights, because I remain strongly concerned that there will be significant impact should there be construction directly north of it.
Thank you for your comments. We'll take into consideration. We have your letter in that.
Sure. The other piece is, the carport that's depicted here, and I believe the architect said it couldn't go anywhere else. There are lots of other places for that carport.
We have more than 3 minutes.
No problem. I'll let my wife finish it up. Thank you. If you'd like that, you're certainly welcome to it. I think it's a very helpful document.
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Anybody else like to speak? Label it tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So please come up, state your name and your address. 3 minutes, please, though.
I'm Roger Seiler. I live at 5 Baraka Avenue. And
could you just spell your last name for me?
S-E-I-L-E-R.
Thank you. Go ahead, Roger.
Okay. Just a couple of points that I want to make. One is, I heard mention of Central Avenue. Central Avenue was, the name was legally changed several years ago to Chase Avenue. The reason being, there's another Central Avenue down in Nyack that is causing a lot of problems with people trying to get a taxi to take them to the airport, and they went to the wrong Central Avenue. So anyway, that should be made note of. Regarding the placement of the carport and so on, there are several other examples in the neighborhood of properties where carports are right up against the road, and it doesn't seem to be a problem. So I think that can be considered. Another thing is that due to the strange problems brought about by the nature of the land up there on the hillside, I was on the zoning board, and I was also on the zoning code review commission that rewrote the zoning law in 2005. And one of the things that we did was we gave the planning board special authority to change the requirements on individual properties in order to make it work.
Which we don't do here.
Actually, no, that section was adopted.
Oh, that was adopted?
That's in my comments, yep. The planning board.
I was wondering what that was referring to.
Yes, that is part of the code.
So that might make it easier for you to deal with the problems. And the water is a problem up on that, in that area. So special attention is going to need to be given to dealing with water flow. Okay. Thank you.
Anybody else like to speak?
Okay.
Please state your name and address for the record.
Alyssa Shore, 9 Baraka Avenue. He spoke way too long, so I'll make it quick. I just want to say that we have a lot of houses on Baraka, and then it becomes Terrace, I think, when it leads up to 9W, and they're all built on this same very steep grade, and the homes are built up high on the grade, and the carports are built at street level, and yes, it's a hassle. these people have to have long staircases going from their carports or garages, whatever you want to call them, up to the houses. They have to be shoveled. It's annoying, whatever you want. But there is certainly the ability for the carport to be down at Baraka's level and have very little impact, hopefully, on any of the surrounding houses.
Thank you. Anybody else like to speak?
Hi, my name is Patricia Burchell.
Just spell your last name for me, Patricia.
B-U-R-C-H-E-L-L.
Thank you. And your address?
26 College.
Thank you.
So I've been in my house for just 2 years. The first time I moved in, there was mold in the house, and just mold, no water, and got that all remediated, moved in 6 months later to the spring when they were building Willow Court, and I actually got water in the house, in the entire back end of my house, utility room, storage room, and two bedrooms, and a bathroom. I had multiple remediation people come out, and they said that I would have to tear up everything that I just rebuilt again. And we just ended up doing some waterproofing on the inside, and I can't even dig up the outside because there's a gas line that runs across there. Regardless, the Willow put up the walls, and that did make a huge difference to the amount of mud and water that was sliding down College Avenue. College Avenue pretty much for the last year looked like the parking lot all the time. I have mud on my driveway all the time, and it comes from two ends, comes across from Willow, and it comes across from College, where, if you have to see where my house is, the steep part of College comes down, takes that turn, there's a double sewer there. The water completely misses that double sewer. And when they say that the water goes east to west, it does not. It goes straight down, hits College, it goes down the opposite side that the sewer drains are on, and then catches the sewer drains on the other side. So what it does is anywhere where there's no curbing, it goes straight down the mountain. I have absolutely no soil on my part of the mountain, and it's got to be the same by them. There is a little bit more curbing on the part that's Chase. So that is a good amount of their property, but that is the way the water runs there. It is not necessarily east to west. So that does concern me, mostly for people living on Baraka. They're going to get water from this. So the water, the mud, the sewers, with having this extra water last year, my driveway cracked right in half because I was getting that much water from the building at Willow. And the other thing I want to comment on is, if you're going to have a carport up there, there's no reason why you have to have it covered. Why should it have to be covered to be up there to make it such an eyesore? You should be able to have it just as a raised driveway with a fencing around it or poles around it. That's it. Thank you.
On College, where are you, east or west of the... this project?
On the one on the island, 26.
Okay.
It's all the way to Tim.
So,
right.
And Willow is the street above it, the wide street?
Yes.
That is never finished off? Thank you. Anybody else like to make any statements from the public? Anybody else in the public? Have a motion for the public?
Move the public portion to be closed.
Mr. Andrews, do I have a second? Mr. Planahan, all in favor? All right. Question, for the base, the concrete that you're going to put for the post, is there any blasting going to be done?
No.
No blasting, okay. DEME, Mr. Peters made a recommendation, number one, about moving the house or the garage a little bit.
He recommended moving the house 16 to 18 feet west.
Which would be right on the road.
Yes.
But I would like you to just take a look at moving the garage so that those two big trees remain up there because of the stone wall below. And where's the water going to run from the roof of the garage?
That's the roof leader line up here.
It's going to go
goes into the detention system.
And the detention system is exactly what?
It's two closed 48-inch pipes that drain into that manhole.
If it goes all the way down there?
That manhole looks like this on the inside, so there's a sump. As the water increases in the manhole, it goes into the drain pipe that goes out to the level spreader.
Okay.
Mr. Peter's concern, which he voiced to me at the PRC, was that if this was an infiltration trench, there could be the possibility of blowing out on the side. It's not an infiltration trench. So Spiracco is looking at adjusting the lengths, pulling it off the easement. He was concerned about the easement. So we're looking at how we're going to address Mr. Peter's comments.
Right.
And at the same time, our engineer will speak to him.
Yeah, and I think it's just to take a look at moving the garage a bit so that those two large trees remain.
Those trees are 36 and 24, not 42.
So 26 and 34, quite large.
What kind of trees are they?
That's tree number 24 and 25, so they're both maples. That's on the tree list, it's on the...
Right.
Can I possibly make a suggestion? What if you were to reposition the house so that the south side of the house was on the west side and the north side of the house on the east side? And you moved it downhill and then put your carport, you'd have enough room to put your carport, which would be, I think, would have a pretty good distance off the road.
That pushes the whole house to a point where it needs more variances and will conflict with the easements that we have on the property already. We've moved this thing 10 times. And we're still stuck with having to, well, we were able to pull it up to the front yard, not needing a front yard variance for the main house. But if we go to the east, not only does it increase the difficulty for construction, but it will interfere with the easement that we've already reconfigured. And the sewer easement is one of the biggest problems we have on the property, because it just essentially takes 10 feet away from us in terms of how we can maneuver the house.
I mean, well,
and you can see
this plan is so busy, I can't see,
right.
I can't see where the easements are or anything like that, but
I understand.
It looks like if the house was built the way I suggested, and not knowing where the easements are or anything like that, the property looks plenty wide enough where I don't think you would need side yard easements, front easements, or anything like that if you moved it to the back.
Yeah, I'm sure you
might be, I mean, not easements, but variances. I would suggest they could come back in with another plan that shows all those easements. Make it a lot easier for us to see how the house was arranged on the property.
We're going to remove all of the steep slope information from this drawing, and that will make it pretty clear. That's what's confusing a lot of things right now.
Right, and you'll have a separate grading drawing.
Yes.
Just removing that's not going to make this drawing as clear enough, but you even clearer.
Right now, this is the building envelope line.
Yeah, I know that.
No, right here.
Yeah.
That's not this. This is the sewer easement.
I know.
This
is
so moving it this way.
I mean, if the house is going to be built on stilts, and you're going to build over a sewer line, I don't know if you do that. You're not putting anything into the ground except for the footings for your pillars.
No, we're not allowed, to build any easements at all. Which is one of Mr. Peter's comments about the walkway that goes over the That's just going to lay on the ground. It needs to be moved, it can be picked up and moved. There'll be no footings or anything within that sewer.
It sounds like from the comments, you know, the biggest concern, or one of the biggest concerns is potential damage for runoff.
Right, and we have a mitigation plan.
And again, that would be detention, not detention, right?
Detention.
Right. Maybe to help me understand a little bit, you know, the carport was there or not there, the carport not being there would cause the same amount of runoff?
It won't change anything.
Won't change anything.
The roof is designed to capture the stormwater so we can put it into the detention system. If we have a carport that's pitched to the street, so you're not, and then we're putting the water in the street. Now we have to mitigate that too. So either way we go, we're mitigating something.
Anybody else have any questions or comments?
Yeah, the manhole is about 7 feet deep, right? So it's going to have to be excavated.
Yes.
You know, I'd like to see what the limits of disturbance are for the foundation as well. So the foundation plan here, there's, and you showed your piers. But, you know, as we overlay this, you know, what the disturbance is going to be. So this is going to be foundation, and these are all piers on the outside, right?
That's correct.
So I guess I'd like to see what the impact of this foundation would be. And then I'd like to see some kind of detail on the piers as well, right? I mean, how deep do these piers go?
They have to be a minimum of 36 inches deep.
Minimum, right? So, okay.
That's a building code.
36?
36. Deep.
How tall is deep?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
No, our building code says 36.
So you're going to have 11 of those at minimum of 36. So, when there is going to be some significant, you know, excavation for this construction. That's all I have.
Okay.
You do the silt fence and everything, you can show on the plans, it has to be there's three panels behind it to support it.
Yeah. We'll have all those details.
I would
ask for a continuance.
Okay.
And we'll get together all of these other items.
Yeah, we need it.
Address the comment.
We need addition, we need landscape plans, we need the easement plans, we need all the things that are missing because they're not here if this comes back again. And I think they do something about take a look at moving that garage so those trees remain, possibly moving the Can Hosky moved to the east a bit so that the carport will be in the front of the house. So there'll be less disturbance on the land on the other side. And how big is that drain you were showing me that on Bacharach? That's the one you have the diagram of? The storm drain down here? Is that the one on the property?
No.
This one? Is that
no.
You have right there?
Yeah, that's just detail out.
Okay. Does anybody know who put that in?
Well, that's proposed.
Was it the state or?
That's proposed. What we're talking about now is proposed.
Okay. But I'm talking about the catch basin and that clause.
I don't even know where it
is. Can I answer?
Sure.
The original developer, when they did that, was part, I mean, Ron contractor was living there, but I did a lot of research before we bought our house. And my understanding is the original developer was required to put in baraka, willow, all the retaining walls, the low baraka, and that, I call it a catch basin, I don't know what to call it. But yeah, and there's like a grass road that you can access from baraka that zigzags down around that catch basin and then winds up on 9W. It's not a real road, and all that land that houses all that, it was owned by the village, and now I guess it's owned by the town.
Do you know who maintains that?
Well, that's a million-dollar question. I believe that River Ridge Estates, the LLC that still is building on Willow and Baraka, maintains all of that, because when a tree fell across the unimproved part of Baraka, they sent their landscapers to clean it up. They send their landscapers to clean the road. And where my car is parked blocks that green grass road. And they've asked me numerous times, oh, can you move your car because we have to go down and maintain that.
Right.
I don't think it's the next one.
Thank you.
The
bond. No, no, there is one.
I'm sorry.
To the bond and do a subdivision, you have to put bond down. Everything is done. Can't find myself while they're looking.
We inherited this, so
yes,
unfortunately none of us have the back history.
Right. Okay. All right, you'll be notified when the next meeting is. There's no decision tonight. We've asked them to do some things, come back. Well, this is what I wanted. This last thing here. What is this drain down here?
It's a stormwater drain on Baraka. And the other drain that was talked about is this one here.
Right.
The top water goes by that instead of dumps into that.
All right, thank you. Next on the agenda is the Tri-B resubdivision plan and Tri-B re-site plan.
I'll say, I think that seat's on fire.
Mr. Chairman, we want to do these both at the same time.
Building.
increase in your population, it's the same size, it's just we're consolidating buildings. That's what subdivision, we have it through the two lots together, and the rest will be granted building as well. Please would like to build the building.
I just want to add something to that. Tom Bertuzzi, you all probably know him, he's been here for a long time. There was a fire in the main building, and as a result of that, it was a little bit scary. And what he wanted to do was look into ways of knocking down the existing building, which is on the easterly small tax lot, knocking down the garage, and consolidating the units that are in the existing apartment building, and making a nice new structure in a courtyard shape, which I think was one of the things that came out of the consultation, and upgrade the parking lot, upgrade the safety features, eliminate the existing older structure, and remodel everything. And the subdivision is getting rid of the tax lot line, and then the site plan is knocking down the existing stuff, the existing house and the garage, and putting in the L shape. So the subdivision, if everything doesn't go through with the site plan, the subdivision would not occur. You would just leave it as is. But what we're really trying to do here is upgrade everything, get rid of the old wooden apartment building, and upgrade everything in a U-shaped courtyard with a better parking area, better circulation patterns, and so on.
Which one are you doing first?
Site plan or subdivision? Which one are we reading? Subdivision first?
Yes.
Okay. And let me know what I missed on that because sometimes it's difficult. Okay. Office of Building and Zoning Planning Administration Enforcement, dated January 23rd, 2023. Two comments.
Mr. Chairman, number two was taken care of.
Oh, okay. Number two has been corrected. We have the second. Read number one. The applicant proposed to merge lot 5.1 and lot 5.2. OBC PAE has no objection to request the merger. The Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, Town of Orangetown, February 6, 2023. Has one comment, and this department has no comment on the project at this time. Brooker Engineering, letter dated February 7, 2023. Applications demonstrate there are no potential significant impacts with respect to drainage. For required mitigation, we therefore recommend that the Tri-B Health PP site plan be approved.
Brooker only sent one letter, so
okay.
That really relates to the site plan.
Right.
He wouldn't be commenting on the subdivision.
Okay. Bureau of Fire Prevention, one under site plan review, one bullet. Okay. Rockland County Department Planning, January 27, 2023. They say disapproved. They have 25.1 comments.
Right, and I think
but this all seems to be for the site plan and not for the re-subdivision, so.
That's correct.
So this is that a comment on that?
Well,
Mr.
Chairman.
Yes.
They do speak about some things about the subdivision, about the tax lots. For instance, number 20, there's a couple of things that relate to it.
Yeah, I think, but the letters are identical, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, they are.
It's the same letter.
No change. We're going to have a problem with the letter if you want to pick it up later on, so you can use the
same. I think you definitely need to pick up whatever is in reference to the subdivision, if something needs to be, if the applicant's going to request them to be overridden, it has to be part of the package and specifically enumerated, so we know.
Number six relates specifically to the subdivision. Number seven relates to the subdivision.
Oh, yeah, subdivision, hot temperature, right?
Right, which obviously that, you don't need an override on that.
Correct. No, we're fine with that.
Seven?
Seven, same thing.
No comments necessary.
To some degree, number two relates to the subdivision because I don't know what bulks to use, and they're speaking about multifamily uses in this zone. And we're going to have to ask for an override for number two and number one, as well as some other things that we want to go through when we get to the site.
Right, but as far as the re-subdivision goes, I think it's just six and seven. We should see something else.
Right, Jay, the merger of the two lots.
Correct.
It's just a merger.
Yep.
So one and two should be addressed as part of the site plan.
Okay.
Right. So six and seven would be the only ones that refer to the re-subdivision. And let's just stand, you have no objection to those?
No. No.
Okay, so then the others do not refer to the re-subdivision.
Except maybe one and two, if you want to take it.
We'll go with the site.
So we would like, if you grant us one and two and the site plan, we will have it carry over to the subdivision.
Say that again?
He says
that if they grant one and two override for the site plan, we would say that same override would go for the subdivision.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know that two would need to be overridden. They're just saying the town must consider the cumulative community impacts of permitting such development before granting approvals. It's really not.
It's an existing.
I mean, ultimately, I make the zoning determination.
Right.
Not county planning.
Right.
So I have done that in my, you know, when you get to site plan.
Right.
So my point is, though, number two, I don't think there's anything to be overwritten. It's more advisory.
Okay.
And so I would say.
Well, should we make that a statement in there?
We can make it a statement. One and two actually have to do with site plan. But I think it was already stated that number six and seven are the only thing that have to do with the subdivision.
Right.
Okay.
So we say, six and seven, you have any problems? You have no problems with number seven. And the other
comments reference the site plan.
Reference the site plan, okay. Okay, Rockland County Sewer District number one, letter dated January 20th, 2023. That's two comments. Rockland County Highway, January 6th, 2023. Consensus of the Orange County Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Planning Department, 1623, consensus of the County of Orange County Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Department of Health, 11113, that should be corrected to 11123 based upon the order of the letter. Consensus of the County of Orange County Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Orange County ZBA, 1423, consensus of the town. Orange County Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Planning Department, 1623, comments attached. Orange County ZBA, 1423, no future correspondence with site should be sent to this agency. And as reviewed, the HC does not have any further comments. Rockland County Highway Department, January 6th of 23, no comments at this time. A letter from Donald Brenner, dated January 30th, 2023, called when I say SEAF, short environmental assessment form, I'm going to annex it. That's the short EAF 1129 of 22, revised 12723. Okay, do we have anything else?
Another Rockland County Highway.
About the Rockland County Highway, the one six?
Site plan review.
Oh, we just did subdivision.
Okay.
Now we're going to do site plan, right?
Yep.
Now we're going to do subdivision.
It should be the other one.
Okay, that was site plan, I'll do the subdivision.
No, no, the other way.
We did subdivision, now we're going to do site plan.
Site plan, we're doing site plan.
Should we vote on the subdivision?
Yes, it should.
You want to stay with subdivision?
Yeah, you have to, you have to.
All right, then we'll go to site plan.
You at least have to remember to vote on them separately.
Okay.
I thought they were going to have public speak for both and address both and then vote separately after the public.
Right, but I just want to remind you, you have to.
Okay, two separate, okay. All right, so now we're going to cover the driving site plan for 120 and 122 Central Raven for the river. Project review has no additional comments beyond the comments submitted by other agencies. Office of Building and Zoning Planning Administration Enforcement, letter dated January 26, 2023. There are 15 comments. Following Environmental Management Engineering, letter dated February 6, 2023. There are 13 comments. Bureau of Fire Prevention, we have Brooker Engineering, February 7, 2023. The application has demonstrated that no potential significant impact with respect to drainage will require mitigation. We therefore recommend that by BLPD site plan be approved for drainage subject to the above project comments, which there are five. Bureau of Fire Prevention, January 26, 2023, the site plan review, five comments. Rockland County Department of Planning, January 27, 2023, they have 25.1 comments. The exact same letter was submitted for the resubdivision.
They are going to request some override.
We'll go through all of it and then come back for the override.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Just if we could start with Jane Slavin's letter of the 26th. I would like to have some guidance as to what parking requirements I should use so we know what variance we're going to need. I don't really know what applies here. Is it ones per half dwelling, so there's two per unit?
I'm not going to answer that off my hip, but you put calculations on it. That's why, how did you come up with it? What'd you use?
I use one per unit. What should I use?
Then you're pretty sure for, right?
We're going to need a variance no matter what.
Right.
There's a non, it's non-conforming right now.
But it's also in,
well, I told you what to use, right?
One per half.
Applicant must advise us what parking they are applying to achieve, to arrive at 22 spaces per chapter 43, table 3.1, CS district column 6, same as R80, R80 district column 6 residences, at least one parking space for each half dwelling. 22 apartments would then result in 44 spaces being required.
Okay, so that's what we'll need the variance from.
There's also a comment in
the county.
Rockland County about handicap.
Back to them.
Yeah.
About handicap parking spaces.
Okay, Rockland County. Highway Department, letter dated January 10th, 2023.
Well,
three comments. Okay, Rockland County Center for Environmental Health, January 11th, 2023. One comment. Rockland County Sewer District number one, January 20th, 2023. Two comments. Abu Dhabi, Orange of Rockland Utilities, email January 3rd, 2023. Proposed work may be harmful to the existing gas service. It seems an additional load most likely be required for the site. Orange Town ZBA, 1 January 4, 2023, consists of Town of Orange Town Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Department of Health, 1/11/23, consists of Town of Orange Town Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Planning Department, 1 January 9, 2023, consents to the Town of Orange Town Planning Board Service Lead Agency. Rockland County Planning Department, January 9th of 23, comments attached. Rockland County Department of Health, January 11th of 23, comments attached. Orange Town ZBA, January 4th of 23, no future correspondence to the site should be sent to this agency. Plan reviewed, and this agency does not have any further comments. Okay, this is a project narrative. Submitted, okay, site, and short EAF dated 11/29, which was revised at 11/27/23. Is that everything? Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, Mr. Andrews.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Could we just go through a couple of comments, please, so that it may solve a lot of the issues that you may have?
Sure.
We're going to revise the plan to reflect the number of parking spaces as indicated. Some of the things we talked about at project review, we're going to put bollards to prevent the cars that are alongside the buildings to prevent them from hitting the building. We're going to provide the retaining wall details. We've confirmed that the height of the structure is less than 30 feet, so we're going to satisfy the fire inspector. The short EAF, as you noted. The total new impervious area is less than 100 square feet. We also committed at project review to provide some additional landscaped areas at the corners. For instance, in the striped areas that are shown at the southwest corner, at the northeast corner, and at the southeast corner, Bruce Peters had mentioned possibly putting in mountable curving, which we have no objection to. We're going to fix the sidewalk and curbing at the northwest corner. We did look into the idea that Bruce Peters had raised, which was taking the road that goes around the back of the building and just connecting it directly to John Street, but it doesn't work grade-wise. It ends up being way too deep. It exposes the foundation. It's 8 feet deep at the southwest corner and about 4 feet deep at the southeast corner. There's just no way we can catch it.
You'd have to put a railing up too because of the doors there, the entrances.
Correct. It just wouldn't work. We'd need, and it would also require a retaining wall that would make a tunnel, which would make it more difficult to maneuver emergency vehicles through the site. So we looked at that, and we just can't do it. It would be nice, but we can't.
It'll bring you closer out to Central Avenue.
Right.
Which in the winter, with ice there, but.
We agree we will put in the concrete curb along John Street. We have no objection to the other comments that Bruce raised. Again, we're okay with, we're going to widen the entrance at 20 feet at East Central. This is Dave Majewski's comment. And then we can get to the county level. Do you want to do that first, or do you want to go through?
Go through the comments and then. Mr. Andrews.
Yes. I love the idea of the courtyard. I think that looks pretty good. One other comment that I don't see an area for like a garbage bin or anything like that.
That's a good point. We'll probably have to flip that into some of those striped areas that we're going to be putting in the mountable curbing.
And then, I guess the roadways are all going to be big enough for the garbage truck to get in and out because they have to be big enough for fire apparatus. How many units are going to be in this?
22. Sam's, what's that?
So it's 22 spaces also, right? Parking spaces.
Well, we don't have 22 spaces. We have.
It's only 19.
We have 19, and we have to accommodate. We may lose one more, making three into two handicapped. We may lose one more.
less than that. 16, I think you have that.
So, where are the people going to park? I mean, assuming 22 people in the building, each one has a car.
More than that, some of the units are one bedrooms, right?
Several of the units are one bedroom, yes. What we do now for numerous of our places we have, it's more of a first-come, first-served basis. When we lease deed property, we tell them they cannot have a car on site. And we, the people who are allowed to have a car on site, they have a right to lease if they can. It is in the middle of a town where a lot of people don't have vehicles.
Okay. Right. Just, does the town have, well, that whole, they have public parking somewhere.
There is street parking, but not during winter.
Yeah.
Because they are their emergency search routes.
Isn't there municipal parking lots?
It's about two blocks away.
Not two blocks
away. Typical, I mean, municipal parking lot is not typically used as a trade-off for a parking variance.
Okay. All right,
we have to make our pick through the zoning board for the variances.
Yeah, just something to think about. I don't have anything further.
Mr. Fishian? Mr. Mori?
Yeah, kind of like what Amy said, I got concerns about parking. Where's everybody going to park? You know, to 22 units. Oh, with the new units, there's only 4 units in this three-story building?
That's correct.
And is the building that's being ripped down, there's 4 units in there.
The one that's going in, this is going to be 3 stories.
There's going to be 4 that's units in that also.
4 units in 3 stories. Now with it being the fire prevention you didn't mention yet, are there sprinklers in these? I know you mentioned there was a fire prior.
There wasn't before. We've now fully sprinklered the existing building with the full intention of putting the right size.
Yeah, and this is going
to be fully sprinkled.
You got 3 stories, otherwise you'd have to have a fire sprinkler.
Yes, it's going to be fully sprinkled. We have since upgraded it to be fully sprinkled in the last year.
Yeah.
And the new dish will be fully sprinkled also.
All right. Yeah, my only concern is the lack of parking in this plan. And what happens is they end up parking on the streets and the neighboring streets, you know, the Long John and elsewhere. But that seems to be a big sticking point with a few of these letters anyway. Well, that's my only comment, just the lack of parking.
Thank you. Ms. Nye.
Yeah, same thing, the concern about the parking. Are the buildings going to be connected in any way? Or they're butting up to each other? Are they?
No, they're going to be like two
separate. Right.
We're going to do stairwell in, and it's just going to connect up to each other.
And then one of the other comments in there was access. You only had it from the one. Are there no other entrances or doors or egress from, or it's just the one in the front?
There's the one in the front. There's one in the back.
Okay.
And there's going to be, my report, one on each side. There's one on the front, there's one on John Street side, there's one in the front on the Central Avenue side, there's going to be one on every north, south, east, and west.
The two doors on the John Street side, are they for units or are they access to the building?
One is just for a unit, the other is for the entire, for the use for all the units.
All right, yeah, it's just not depicted like that, right?
There's no exit doors on the east
right,
side.
Right, these are connected.
They're not connected.
So there's just one entrance, you're not really touching this, except the landscape
right.
or whatever around it. So you only have one entrance for 4 units here.
I think that's correct. The egress, fire egress would be out the window, would be on the east side.
That's
correct.
So, Jay, can I just kind of step up onto that question there? How are the 4 units going to be laid out, the new units?
Two on the bottom.
So there's 4 units in that new section, and there's 16.
Well, what we're going to do is reconfigure some of the units that are, so it's going to be after it's done, because I believe you, Mr. Mayor, who recommended us doing 3 stories, we're going to reconfigure these units over here to put 2 over here. So this, if you'll notice, some of these in the units that are in the bottom are not well laid out for lack of a better term. So we're going to eliminate ones over here and move them over to the new structure. because this structure was recommended, which I thought was a great idea, that we're going to raise it, and that's why our height, we're still under 30 feet, and then therefore, there's no subterranean unit, for lack of a better term. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
Mr. Perry?
I think it looks like a good play. Good luck.
Thank you.
So we're showing the building height on the plans, correct?
Yes.
All right, you saw Bruce's comments about the retaining wall, here we made up stone.
Yep.
Have you engineered?
Yes, we went over that at the project review. We confirmed that there'd be a segmental block wall, engineered wall. It's not going to be a laid up wall.
Yeah, no, it's going to be, we try to come around that turn
yep.
there. Okay. Now, okay, the demo unit had four units in it. How many, what were they? One or two bedroom or studio?
One, two, three single units, one studio.
Okay. And the new four units are going to be?
Four single.
Four single, okay. The same number of toilets, same number of showers?
Correct.
Okay. And you're going to use ballards around the building? Are you talking about the east side of the building? The parking is, now you're parking parallel to the building there, right?
Yes, we're going to widen that. We talked about that at project review. We showed it as a 22-4-foot aisle and a 10-foot wide space and 2 foot of landscaping. We're going to increase that to 4 feet of landscaping and a 22-foot aisle.
Okay, I'm talking about now between the building and the parking space itself.
I believe it's recommended to put in bollards, and
yes.
I'll do whatever the recommendation is.
Okay. So when they're backing in, they're not going to back into the building?
So back into the bollard.
Okay. That's on the, be on the east side and the north side, and the south side.
And the north side.
And south.
Right.
Everything but the west.
Okay. There's nothing on the west side. Okay. That's all the comments I have at this time. Motion to open public portion.
Motion.
Sorry. Anybody from the public like to make a comment at this time? Anybody like to make a comment from the public at this time? Hearing none, I ask the motion to
close. Close.
Mr. Andrews, just want to give a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Now you have, you want to make some questions, comments, or globalize it, you mentioned before?
We would like to have more of a relationship.
Spaces is increasing, and the overall resulting plan will be an improvement over what is currently existing.
So you're increasing from 16 to 19?
Correct.
For the same height.
And the same number of units, correct.
And two are going to be handicapped, which we have zero now.
That's called a zoning gateway, right?
Yeah, you don't have to go to ZBA for variance time. So, but for the override, we're going to give a rationale. So the rationale for number one for the override. Should we vote on each override separately, or?
We have to make a vote.
Okay,
do
I
have
motions? Barry, do you want two together?
Well, I think Jane was right in that number two says the town must consider the cumulative
right.
impacts. It doesn't say that we shall
right.
have to change the plan. So two is, if you're satisfied that you've looked at it, then
right.
that's enough. We don't need an override on number two.
Okay, number one, the override would be, we have a motion, Mr.
Okay,
Ferry.
Make a motion override.
Mr. Andrews seconds it. All in favor? All right. Okay, the rationale is they're increasing the number of parking spaces from 16 to 19. The number of units has not changed, and they will be going to the CBA for a variance on this.
And Mr. Chairman, we would like.
Wait a minute, it's not done.
I'm sorry.
the number of units is existing?
Yeah, same number of units, no increase in the number of units.
Okay.
Parking was increased from 16 to 19.
Parking increasing 16 to 19.
And we'll be going to the ZBA for variance. Item two will be considered. And just put down a number of units of the same there.
For number two?
Yeah, this is the same number of units. They say undesirable overutilization. It's no
it
change.
It was considered, to, however, it's the same number of units.
Right. We have to, should we override on that one? Just leave it considered. Okay. Number three. No problem, number three?
No.
Number four. Any problem?
No.
No.
Number five?
No.
Number six?
No.
Subdivision.
Number
six and seven are subdivision.
Oh, that's right, we did those already. Six and seven. You can put it on there. Six and seven were
subdivision.
Referred to subdivision.
No problem with eight,
no.
Nine, 10, 11. We're going to provide a landscape plan. Number 12 is fine. We'll consider native species. 13.
Okay. So, yeah, actually, for a road, right? It's no. Okay. Number 13?
No.
Okay. 14?
No.
15?
No.
Can I have a lighting plan?
We will.
Okay. 16?
No.
16, we have to fix that. Jane pointed out the same thing in her memo. Yes, that's fine. We'll take care of that. But 17, we do need an override.
17, we need an override.
Site proposes 8 parallel parking spaces near the adjacent outer walls. This parallel space proposes perpendicular parking the result of vehicle table types being only a few feet away from apartment windows. Reaching from idling vehicles may have a serious impact on indoor air quality for residents depending on location of the windows. Planning board must consider the potential health impacts of parking layout considering the location. What have we done to...
Well, you did increase the planting island from 2 to 4 feet, so...
Okay. That's between the building and parking?
Sure, that's right.
Okay. So planting...
So then you don't need an override.
That's true. I guess, again, this one actually says the planning board must consider and shall consider the relocating, and we did what
okay.
we can. On the south side, we really can't do anything in increasing it, but...
All right. So there's no
override. Right, well, parking spaces to a greater distance from the structure.
Right.
You made it, you went from 2 feet to 4 feet.
Right, and you closed up one of these wells in front.
True.
So no idling signs? Right?
Yeah, but you're not allowed to idle more than a certain number of minutes.
Are you looking for an override on this, or?
What is it?
53 minutes.
Wow.
I don't think so. You addressed it.
Consider it. Considered, okay.
Consideration.
Well, it was considered, and they agreed
okay.
to move to from 2 feet from the
okay.
building to 4 feet from the building, correct? You're agreeing to that?
We did.
Okay.
Yeah. So we don't need an override on that. That's just a condition.
It's, right.
Yeah.
You guys are satisfied. It's saying you shall consider. You considered, and if you're satisfied, then that's...
I just want to be clear. It's as many spots as we can from 2 to 4. There's some that are staying the same distance.
But they're about 4 or 5 feet away on the south side.
They're,
so
right,
they're not as
they
close.
Are. So I just want to be clear. Every spot. I don't want to, you know, misconceive
everybody.
It's been considered.
All right.
Okay.
Number 18?
No.
Number 19?
We are putting the ball in, yeah?
Yep.
Right. Okay.
No problem with 19, 20. 21,
22, 23, 24,
and 25.
Okay. We'll change it from the United
Water
to the
OEA. Yeah.
Okay. Well, from Spring Valley to United to Suez.
Okay.
Okay.
Any other comments from the board?
I'll make just one more comment. You guys are going to come back to the layout of each apartment? And you know,
if you'd like, we've already got preliminary plans.
All right.
Yeah,
like you said, it seems like a lot of space for three-story, and you're saying there's going to be one bedroom apartments?
That's correct.
All four of them?
That is correct. Well, two, and now we're doing the two on the bottom also, so it is set.
I'd just like to see it.
Yeah, no problem. It's already preliminary done. It doesn't have structure, you know, low bearing calculations, it has basic plans.
How big is the apartment, is 30?
That I don't remember off the top of my head. I'm sorry, I don't.
Andy?
Okay. Do I have a motion for lead agency?
Motion.
Mr. Ferry, second?
Second.
Mr. Andrew, second, all in favor?
Aye.
Do I have a motion for a?
We'll do one of the parts.
That was lead agency on the re-subdivision. Do I have a motion for a negative deck on the re-subdivision? Mr. Ferry, Ms. Lanning, second. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. Do I have a motion for preliminary with conditions? Mr. Ferry? Next time, come back with the second one, then come back a month later with the other. Office of Building Zoning Plan Enforcement Administration, January 23rd, 2023. One comment, the second comment has already been corrected. Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, letter dated February 6th, 2023, one comment. Off Bureau of Fire Prevention, letter dated January 24th, 2023, one bullet on the site plan. Rockland County Department of Planning, letter dated January 27, 2023, comments 6 and 7 apply to it. The other comments apply to the site plan rather than subdivision. Rockland County Sewer District Number 1, letter dated January 20, 2023, two comments. I think that's all. Any comments? Nothing missed? Okay. Do I have a motion? Do I have a second on that?
Second.
Mr. Andrews, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, preliminary on the
subdivision.
Okay, now I can go.
Motion to.
Motion for lead agency?
For lead agency.
On the site plan?
Yes.
Mr. Andrews, Ms. Lanahan, second.
Mr. Chairman, if I'm sorry, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I just realized that the subdivision is published for preliminary, preliminary, and final. So if the board wants to consider final for that, I guess you just have to.
Motion.
You have to make a motion. Yeah.
All right, back to the re-subdivision of the new location.
Do you have to do, sorry, I've never done that one before. If you've already made a decision, do you have to do anything to rename your previous decision?
They can just revoke.
Okay.
Okay, motion to revoke the previous decision.
No, no, you just revoke. Hold on, let me just make a note that we're revoting.
Mr. Fowler.
Motion for a final.
Final. Resub. Thank you.
Motion for final. We read the comments already. Okay. Do I have a second? Other one.
Second.
Mr. Vigiani. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
So that one's so that up.
Okay.
So, and then we had Mr. Andrews, and was it the same vote for site plan, or do we have to revote?
We're just starting the site plan.
All right, start again.
They just did lead agency
for site plan.
Yeah. Right. Does that vote stand, or we have to redo it?
So.
Site plan. Now we're going to preliminary.
No, we're doing.
They did lead agency.
We did lead agency.
Right.
I
have a motion for a negative deck.
Motion.
Mr. Ferry, Mr. Andrew, second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Read the conditions. Okay, Office of Building and Zoning Planning Administration enforced in January 26, 2023. 15 comments. Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, letter dated February 6, 2023, we have 13 comments. Brooker Engineering, February 7, 2023, 5 comments. Bureau of Fire Prevention, site plan review, 5 comments. Rockland County Department of Planning, there are 25.1 comments. Comment number 1 was overridden. Comments 6 and 7 refer to the re-subdivision. And I think that was it as far as Rockland County Highway Department, letter dated January 10, 2023, 3 comments. Rockland County Center for Environmental Health, letter dated January 11, 2023, 1 comment. Rockland County Sewer District number 1. Letter dated January 20th, 2023, we have 2 comments. Alfred Gotti, Orange and Rockland, January 3rd, 2023, 1 comment. I think that's all.
And then just the sign-offs, yeah.
Okay. Do I have a motion for final? Oh, we got that right, I'm sorry. Second. Second by Mr. Andrews, all in favor?
Preliminary.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, everyone. Have a good night.
Okay. Let's just, before you put the ZBA application in, let's make sure everything's...
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
Of the building. We want to do a expansion on the south side of the building, roughly squaring off the building. It has an L shape now. We'd like to square it off. The purpose is the current owner just bought the property about a year ago. The previous owner was the electrical company that is there now, and they signed a 10-year lease to stay there. It's a family-owned business where they own the business and the building. But for some reason, they wanted to sell the building after like 50 years. My client bought the building and would like to bring it, would like to do the addition specifically for another company. It's Atlantic Label, who's in Valley Cottage right now. They make the labels for the food, like they make the labels for the soup cans and the bread, whatever. They make labels for thousands of food products. So that, this is gonna be a custom build for them. I went to the review meeting, and there was some comments, which some I already took care of. So actually, the building you're looking at, it's going to be slightly smaller, so we can actually put a road around the entire building.
like there is now. Right now, there's a road around the entire building. The initial application cut that off, and then after talking with Dave, it's better to have the roadway for emergency vehicles. So that's the slight change we're gonna make to the what you're looking at now.
How many square feet are you reducing? Where exactly are you?
Adding.
Right. No, you're reducing what you originally
proposed. Oh, it reduces it by about 2,000 square feet.
Okay, what is that reduction going to be off?
At the southwest corner, so we can have a roadway that goes around the entire building.
Okay.
So that's adjacent to Il Fresco restaurant, if you're familiar with the lot.
All right. Il Fresco is, that's west of you, correct?
Yes, Il Fresco is west of us.
Okay. Oh, so it's that corner you're reducing?
Yes.
So you're right by the property line?
Correct.
And
it also helps because then I don't believe we don't need the side setback in because it'll be further than the closest side.
No, is the proposed new side yard in performance?
No, it still needs it. Okay. Yep. So it'll still be closer than 100 feet,
right,
but not as close
not
as
it
was.
Right.
Any comments here? PRC has no additional comments beyond the comments submitted by other agencies for this project. Office of Building and Zoning Planning Administration Enforcement, January 27, 2023. There are 13 comments, and we need a correction on the short environmental.
Yes, I'm aware of that, yes. That will be taken care of.
Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, they have 29 comments. Brooker Engineering, letter dated February 7th, 2023. The application has demonstrated that potential significant impacts with respect to drainage can be mitigated. We therefore recommend that the East Coast BLR 1993 LLC site plan be approved for drainage subject to the above project comments. Bureau of Fire Prevention, letter dated January 24, 2023. Five comments on the site plan review and four bullets on the construction plan. Rockland County Department of Planning, letter dated January 26, 2023. There are 26.1 comments. Rockland County Center for Environmental Health, letter dated January 11, 2023, one comment. Rockland County Sewer District number one, letter dated January 20, 2023, there are two comments. Email from Alfred Gaddy, Orange and Rockland, dated January 3rd, 2023. Proposed work may not be in direct conflict with existing service, but a load increase may be required. Developer must verify the location of existing service and contact owner's new business department. Rockland County Planning Department, January 6, 2023, consents to the County of Orange Town Planning Board serving as lead agency. Rockland County Department of Health, letter dated 1st, January 11, 2023, consents to the County of Orange Town Planning Board serving as lead agency. Rockland County Highway Department, January 12, 23, consents to the County of Orange Town Planning Board serving as lead agency. Orange Town ZBA, letter dated January 4th, 2023, consents to the County of Orange Town Planning Board serving as lead agency. Rockland County Planning Department, January 6th, 23, comments attached. Rockland County Department of Health, January 11th, 23, comments attached. Rockland County Highway Department, January 12th, 23, no comments at this time. Please send your correspondence to review. January 4th, 2023, Orange Town ZBA, no comments at this time. We have a narrative from Bart M. Rohde, PE, dated 11-3-22, and a short EAF, which is undated.
And will need to be revised.
It needs to be revised.
Yes.
Okay.
Just, Brooker, you read the date and the start of the letter, just to have to read that it's 10 comments.
Okay. Engineering. I'm sorry, what did I say?
No, you just said that it was Brooker on 2-7, I just...
Okay, Brooker Engineering, February 7th, 2023, 10 comments.
Okay.
Thank you. Mr. Andrews.
So this, you're going to make labels, print labels, or...
Yeah, they did actually make the labels.
Is there going to be any, like, deliveries, where are you going to...
No, this is, it's, they make the labels, the shipping is infrequent, once a week, twice a week, it's not a lot.
So there's no docks or anything like that?
There's three proposed loading docks. The client moving in only needs one of them, but for the size building, if it's appropriate to put three in case he moves out and then he needs for future rental.
And how many employees are there in this company?
I have it on it, that he doesn't have a lot. He currently has 8 employees in his Valley Cottage location. We did the parking for a few more than that, just in case.
Yeah, 13 spaces. Is that going to be enough?
There's more than 13 spaces.
On the south side, 6 and 7 spaces.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's 13. Oh, 13 just for that, yeah, just for that side. And then there's spaces in the front.
Yeah, that's one of my comments to clearly label dimension and number them.
Yep, I saw it.
And you're going to cut a knock off to the southwest, south, red, and fourth.
Yeah, so
we're going to road around.
Right, we're going to have the setback's going to go to a little over 30 feet, so we can put a 20 foot road with 5 feet on either side to get to the back as a fire line. In the winter, it'd be slightly, there's like a 20-foot woods between the two of us that we're not touching. So in the summer, you really can't see. If you go there now, you can see, there's a lot of trees there, but you can see El Fresco. And if you go into the parking lot, because I eat there a lot, you could see the building. Actually, their driveway is actually on our property.
Oh.
Looks like you got a lot of outstanding issues.
Yes, which almost all of them will be taken care of. It's basically standard stuff. There are some things that we probably will not be doing. For example, we're not doing any landscaping whatsoever.
Yeah, well, I was going to bring that up because we like landscaping.
There's really no way to put it unless we cut trees down to put it in. There's
along the these plans we're looking at. These aren't going to be the plans that you're submitting, right? You said these are going to change?
The only change is in the corner, and then I'm going to address all the comments from...
You have fire prevention. You were talking about a turnaround.
I went over that with Dave. The change I already made on the plan I'm looking at here, I know you don't have a copy because you can't resubmit. One, the buildings, we're going to lower the building to 28 feet. 32 feet was just to match what's there, but by lowering it, we don't have the 26 foot requirement. Two, we're putting the road around the entire building, so we no longer need to turn around. I already figured out the fire hydrant to every part of the building.
The plans we have are going to change.
The plans you have are going to change, correct.
So that we'd have a tough time voting.
Correct.
On what we have.
100%. I agree.
I just want to get, correct. We're going to get new plans and.
Yes.
Then that'll be it for my comments.
Okay. Yeah, it's just cleaning some of the stuff up. I don't know where the loading docks are.
Yes, that'll
clean
right.
It up a little
yep,
bit.
Yep, no problem.
All right, that's all for me.
No comments.
Quick ones. All right, so you know you got to submit revised plans.
Yes.
You also have to show, because on the plan here, you're demolishing something, but you don't show it.
Right. Yeah, it's supposed to be shown. It's a very small piece.
I know.
It's shown.
But it's still a piece of the idea.
Right.
So
is that separate demolition? It could be on the site plan, the area that's going to be demolished?
Yeah, ideally, it should be an existing conditioned site plan that shows the area of the building to be demolished.
Yeah, I'll do that.
And then
the new site plan.
And a proposed site plan.
Yep.
Correct.
Are you widening the road as it goes around the back of the building?
No.
So that turn around the back, the fire truck's going to be able to make it?
Yeah.
At the back corner?
We did a turning radius. The largest one will not, the large one that most houses don't have will have to go onto the grass to make that turn.
Cool. I think it's got to be paved something. You talk to fire because they don't want...
Dave seemed to be okay with the existing roadway around it. He just said the new area, make 20 feet. He was okay
so
with
that's
existing.
Going to be paved. Yeah, because the truck is 75,000 pounds.
I know.
And if it's the grass is wet and goes on there, they have truck, fire truck stuff there. Which they brought up at the project review for other projects today.
I understand, but it may be one tire, and it shouldn't get stuck if one tire is even in mud.
It's my recommendation that it should be widened in that corner, so we don't have a problem.
Just adds a lot of impervious for...
Doesn't add that much impervious.
Mm-hmm. You see when you do the turning radius, it adds a lot.
Yeah, because I don't, I can't see it going on the grass. That's what the problem was today. They were talking about it. They didn't even want the. Does that have curving there to turn so they know?
There's no curving here.
Okay.
You know.
All right. Yeah, I've been around those a couple of times.
Yeah.
And the garbage.
Well, there's no exterior garbage now. The dumpster is because he brought a dumpster in temporarily.
Oh, all right.
Because he is downsizing. So part of this also is about 10,000 feet inside, he's going to give to the new tenant.
Okay, no, so couldn't
yeah.
make it around the first time for the garbage truck.
Right. They put a dumpster in to get rid of stuff, and he's getting rid of a lot of stuff. That dumpster's temporary. I'll speak to them to see if they require outside garbage. If they do, we'll have to show a garbage location. If not, it'll all be internal.
Spark Hill Creek goes across your property, correct?
Yes. Yeah, but along the back of the property, or either along the back or adjacent. I think it's behind the property.
Okay, we'd like to see that on the...
I'll confirm. If it's on our property, I'll show it, but I don't think it is. I think it's beyond.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's behind the next property. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you see there's a building behind it?
The reason
I think it's behind that.
I ask is if you look at Rockland County Planning, to make a comment about spot parking.
Right.
Okay. And the new parking spaces, are you going to be close to the front of the building?
There's a few on the front of the building, and there's 13 on the side of the building.
Okay, but not all the way to the back where the spot pit was?
No. It's on, it shows it on
right.
your plan, too. Is
that going to be our current impervious area, or is it going to be new?
That's new impervious area, adjacent to the existing impervious area.
Okay, there's a couple of things that DME revised, the drainage calculations and
that will all be taken care of.
Also, the stormwater management, you have this underground now.
Yep.
Bruce says he wants it above ground.
Well, I think he puts that on almost every...
Yeah, but according to the...
I'll talk to Bruce about that.
Okay.
Because existing, you see what it does existing, right? One of the comments was there's a pipe that goes under the building that I forgot to show you around.
Right.
That's the existing drainage now that drains all the blacktop. It just dumps it onto the property at the front. That's how it exists.
Okay. Not near the swap, though.
No, the other direction,
okay.
Between El Fresco and the bank.
Now, does El Fresco have an easement? Are they driveway there, or is this?
The lawyers are looking into that. They don't believe so, because the owner said years ago they actually had a contract where El Fresco would pay them every year to utilize it.
Okay, so they got to find the contract?
Yeah, but there hasn't been money exchanged in years, so the lawyers are looking to find out what the situation is.
Yeah, because it's, that's the, who's coming to. Okay. Okay, and no further comments.
Can I just one more comment?
Yeah, sure.
I know Jane mentioned in her letter, number 9, but you kind of like downplayed it, but we'd like to see a landscaping plan. Now, especially if you're pulling that building further away, there's probably room to put some plantings between the new extension and a fresco.
There's a woods there now.
Yeah, we don't see that, like it's...
Oh, we need to show the woods.
What are you getting rid of?
We're getting rid of one tree that's inside the footprint of the current building. There's no other trees being removed on this. So we're moving it out, we're moving the parking lot. We're not removing any trees, but there's, as I said, there's basically a woods between us and them that we're not going to touch.
So that we're on the plan, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, not a problem.
The existing site plan should show the outline of the wood there.
Not a problem.
Just give me more info.
Yeah, you got it.
That's all.
Yeah, so you have an existing and then the new site plan, so it's going to be...
Yeah.
Okay, how much of those woods are on your property?
A lot of it towards the side and the back. I'll show it on the plan when we...
On this southwest corner?
The southwest corner? Yeah, that's between the two buildings is all woods there. So some of it's...
How much of those woods is on your property?
Some, and some is on the neighbor's property. You know, as, if you look at that, at the southwest corner, see how there's a little triangular wedge there? That's all woods in there. But I'll do an existing conditions and show it. Or I'll have Jay do it, he did the survey.
Do I have a motion for public portion? Public. So I'm here and see if you second. All in favor?
No.
Okay, anybody from the public want to make a comment at this time? Okay, hearing none.
Motion closed.
Motion closed, Mr. Barry. And second, Mr. Andrews, all in favor? Aye. Okay. We're going to have a mess work continue. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, you can hold on.
Sure. Yeah, I'll request it. Here, just have one question. At what point can I actually go to the zoning board and apply for the variance?
After preliminary.
Okay, so
I'll revise the plans with. As many of the comments that you can address it.
Yep.
Complete.
Yeah, I plan to either put it on or give a narrative of why it's not being addressed. Like a couple of comments were about the SWIP. Well, we don't need a SWIP because it's going to be under an acre of disturbance. So that will be as
you need to work that, whatever that is, out, you have to work that out with Bruce.
I understand. Right. Yeah, I know. I talked to Bruce.
I'm going to show on the plans what the
disturbance area
is.
Not impervious, disturbance.
Disturbance area is.
Yeah, so I will request the continuance to the next meeting.
Not the next meeting.
Not the next meeting.
Or the meeting after that, whatever. Or whenever I submit it to you.
You submit it and then
you get a meeting date.
It gets recirculated.
Yep. Thank you.
Okay, we have two other
beautiful.
I thought we had no one on this phone.
Well, I represent the people who are doing the work at the street, so if you want to ask me any questions on that.
I
have a petition before the town board to do away with that street. That's up near Crooked Hill Road. That's your item number 1. If you
have
the remapping of Second Street.
Right, the Mary and Robin Kavowski. You'd be mapping a portion of Second Street in the Hamlet of Crow River and the town of Orangetown. Those are petitions. Right, this. Want to make any statements before I read the comments?
Primarily, that was a map that was created back in the 20s. It's a paper street. It's never been used. There were 2 or 3. I've already demapped 2 of them. This is the last one. The 4 abutting property owners will be getting a portion of the property. Each one will get a strip from the street.
We have comments here. Department of Environmental Management and Engineering, letter dated February 6, 2023. They have 1 comment. The department has no comment on the project at this time. And from James Dean, Superintendent of Highways, June 14, 2022. Response to recent inquiry, I wish to advise you that this department presently has no intention of utilizing the Baker Street, known as Second Street, from Cookerville Road to Carroll Street and Hamlet Borough to town purposes. There's no interest in accepting or exercising any rights over the same. And will we just refer to the town board, or we have?
Yeah, this, the town board actually votes on this.
Okay.
This is before us because town law 273 requires the town board to send it to the planning board for a report thereon, whatever that means. So I guess just give the town board your position or your opinion if you have any.
Okay, so anybody has an objection to it? The planning board has no objection to the the mapping of the portion of Second Street and refer to the town board as, for the determination of lead agency.
And the town board will be lead agency.
Right. We're saying it's okay for that. Go ahead. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Ms. Andrews' motion. Do I have a second? Ms. Lenahan, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, you got it. You got it on tape, so you can. Okay, zoning text amendment. There's no comments. However, the shorty app is not signed, the data are complete.
Oh, that should be your comment.
That's our comment.
The comment is.
I'm sure the environmental assessment form is totally incomplete, not signed, not dated. That's our comment. Anybody have any, maybe a comment or not?
Any comments on the proposed zoning?
Okay, regarding the zoning amendment, it says here, is the intent of the local law to correct the disparity between existing business B district requirements and the built environment to propagate regulations reflective of the existing built environment? Anybody have any comments on it?
Questions?
They built outside of their district. That's what it is, how they try to incorporate it. Any comments? No comments? Other than environmental assessment form is incomplete.
No other comments?
Right.
Is that what I would write? No other comments?
Okay, we have 4 minutes. Anything with zoning, you have to submit a.
Is it talking about specific locations?
We're talking about the area.
No, it's a zoning text amendment.
Yeah.
So they're changing a portion of the code. Right. They're changing the text of the code. It's not specifically addressing any particular property. It's addressing certain zones.
We have minutes that we have to vote on.
Minutes are from January 11th.
The motion to approve the. Do you have some comments on there from Mr. Andrews?
Let me just make sure nobody here has to not be in there. Everybody here can vote.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now we're did you submit comments on that one? January 11th?
I think I did. I can't remember.
I wouldn't know.
I'm old.
I don't know. Yeah, everybody here can vote on the minutes.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So he would have had comments, he was here.
Yeah,
no,
but
that's not what they
he submitted comments.
He emailed some comments.
He emailed some comments about change good to glad.
I don't see that stuff,
right.
Though. So I don't know that.
Oh, if
you
you
could
ask,
say you could
right.
say as.
Amended?
No, as. What did you say last time?
As corrected.
As corrected.
Just, yeah, we could do that.
Approved as corrected?
Mm-hmm.
You can make your motion that way.
Make a motion. Approve them as corrected?
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Yeah.
Okay, motion for adjournment.
Motion.
Mr. Ferry, Ms. Lenahan, all in favor?
Aye.